coming to medicine, and it's not there. What's not there?
Bingo!
This Saturday at 6:30 in the parish hall, we're going to have a gala bingo evening, and it's going to be fun. I guarantee that. And the price of admission is a goodie, be it cookies or cakes or pie, whatever.
Chocolate pie.
Cherry pie, right. And those things will be auctioned off at the end of the evening with your winnings. And I guarantee each and every one of you that come to play bingo will have won some shekels to use in the auction. And then secondly, last Sunday, if you recall, at the parish fair, we had you vote on whether or not we would want to have a gong show. Well, the gong show won out, so sometime in the future there will be a gong show. And so be thinking of an act to put into the gong show. I know that you're all very creative. So there were a couple of hanging shads, but really the votes were pretty good.
I'm Jackie Hull, and I think a lot of you got an email here a while back about something we're thinking about doing. There's going to be a meeting for the women of the church. Sorry, guys. The women are going to get together. And it's going to be at 10 o'clock on Wednesday in the Guild Room. There's so many interesting and talented and wonderful, fun women in this church, and I think we should get together and get to know each other a little bit better. I don't know how we're going to do that, but I'm sure we can figure it out. If you want to meet in the Guild Room, and let's discuss, do you want a book club? Do you want a movie night? Do you want just a social where we can just get together and have fun and gab and do what women do? I don't know what we're going to come up with, but I'm sure God will guide us, and it will be fun. So if you want to be part of that, come on Wednesday at 10 o'clock here at the church in the Guild Room. If you can't come, let the church office know. Let me know. My name is in the directory or in the phone book. Give me a call and let me know how you feel, what you might want, and we'll do something fun.
And if there's any of you women that are working, obviously 10 o'clock is for probably retired people or people that don't work, talk to me and we'll start another women's group for the working women.
You may notice there are some signs around the church that say something about Laura Gilbert's path to ordination. I'm Laura Gilbert. Just wanted to introduce myself. I am looking at the next step of my path to ordination, and that is a visit to this parish from the Commission on Ministry, which is a group of people from the diocese. And part of their purpose is to interview the congregation about me. So I see that look on your face. So on February 24th, in the evening, 6 o'clock, we are going to enjoy a potluck dinner that will be hosted by the Meals Reception Committee, and we are going to ask everyone who attends to bring either a salad or a side dish or dessert. And we will get together and have a meal, and then I will leave, and you and the Commission on Ministry will spend some time talking about me behind my back. So please join us. Thank you.
A little closer to the mic.
I noticed in the sermon and the readings today we talked about serving others and being a light for others. And this is hard to do if you're one of the the 70 million that they call the wealthy hand-to-mouth. These are people that have a lot, but still live paycheck to paycheck. There are also 1 in 4 Americans who couldn't handle a $400 emergency without having to borrow or charge it. And it's really, really hard to reach out to take care of others if you're under the burden of this kind of financial situation. And so in that light, in helping one another to be able to care for others, St. Mark's is hosting a Dave Ramsey Financial Peace University class that will be starting on Tuesday nights from 6:30 to 8:30 on Tuesday, February 28th, and that will go to April 25th. The only cost is the cost of the materials. If that is prohibitive for you attending, let Father Jim or Pat know. We'll see what we can do to help. If childcare is an issue, let us know. We'll do what we can to help. We just want to help each other to be able to help more people. And when he said serve each other and serve one another, I'm pretty sure he didn't mean with interest.
And you might know someone who would like to take the class. You might want to sponsor them.
Good morning. Have you noticed that Father Jim is glowing a little more today than usual? How many days, Jim? His wife, Maureen Schumer, is coming in on Friday.
Yay!
She'll be here for
12 days.
Counting. 12 days. So next Sunday, after church, we will have a reception welcoming Maureen Schumer, and I hope you'll join us.
Thank you. The vestry, let me also just say, I know we take time for announcements, but this is when the family gathers. This is when we gather around the dining room table, we gather in the study, we gather in the living room, and we share our lives together. And this is a sacrament, our invisible sign of our life together here. And one of the things I want to share with you is the vestry bed and retreat. And by the way, if the vestry members will start to come forward as I speak, as well as those who went off the vestry, please come forward because we're going to commission you. We had a retreat, and what we focused upon was the first part of our vision statement, which I'm sure you've all memorized, but I will not test you on it. But it's about offering the invitation. We won't even call it evangelism. We won't call it proclamation. It's about offering an invitation to share in what we're excited about at St. Mark's. And the vestry explored ways to do that. We actually took a model of a car dealership.
Excuse me.
You don't sell your cars unless you get people to want to come in, and you don't sell cars unless they do come in. So we talked about how do we invite people in the community? How does our facility invite people into this place? And then how do we greet them when they come in? And part of what we want to do is model some ways to share our stories with other people. And Lynn, where are you? Come on down and step to the microphone. I decided last night, the best thing is don't read their emails, don't even know it, is we're going to get kicked off right away in what they have suggested, which is for us to begin to model stories about how we came to the church and why we stayed. And that's a question I'll be asking during these dinner discernment groups that you'll be hearing more about. So Lynn, there are 100,000 different reasons for coming to any church. Let's listen to one of them.
Okay. We came to St. Mark's when our oldest son was about 16. We had been active in another church, and he had acolyted many times, but he had not been confirmed. And in acolyting for the minister at that church, he'd lost respect for him. We stayed at that church because his Sunday school teacher was an awesome woman, and he was learning a great deal from her. Well, confirmation, he was 16, and if he was not confirmed, it wasn't going to happen. The church lost their priest, so confirmation wasn't going to happen anytime soon, and I felt we were at the end of the window for that learning for him. So we came to St. Mark's, where Royce Brown had his respect and was a teacher who could teach with authority. So we moved to St. Mark's for teaching about Christian belief in Jesus with authority.
Thank you, Lynn. One of the things that I've noticed in life, the life cycle of people that attend church and might be raised in the church, when they get confirmed, it's a good thing you did it quickly, Lynn, because as soon as they get their car keys, they're gone. And they'll come back to get married, they'll come back to go to church with their parents, they will come back to baptize their babies, but they leave each time. Maybe some of you have done that. And then when their kids get to be school age, they start thinking, well, it's time to bring the kids back to church. They come back to church, and when their youngest gets their car keys and confirmed who's gone, they're probably gone. And then they come back. Part of what I want us to be thinking about is those transitions that people are going through in life, because those are great opportunities to invite people back to church. So at this point, I would like to thank our outgoing vestry members, Mr. Bond.
No,
no.
Are you keeping me
on? No, I'm Kathy. Dorothy. Where's Dorothy? Dorothy. And Jim, who's not here. We want to give thanks for your service, your voice, your hard work, and your continued commitment to our church. Glad you're both still here. God bless you. And I have gifts for you. I went downstairs to get this and forgot the gifts. But they're beautiful. Rich made them. Maybe I'll show them to you next week. But there are three crosses made out of nails that are fantastic. And I hope you all will accept those and forgive me for forgetting to bring them upstairs. And now I would like to commission the existing vestry. Let's go around and say your names. You can say it loud. Audrey.
Clint Hernandez.
Susan Massey.
Pat
Hanajet. Pat Hanajet. Trouty Gilbert. Oh, you're still on the vestry.
Mike Bond.
Vicki Jasmine.
Mark McAtee. Cheryl Nickerson.
Gary George.
And Gary George. Pat is your senior warden, and Gary is your junior warden. So, I'm going to ask the senior warden these questions. Are they difficult? I don't know. Have these leaders been elected by the congregation or appointed by the vestry in accordance with the bylaws of our congregation? To the new members, do you commit yourselves to carry out responsibilities of the office to which you have been appointed? Do you reaffirm your commitment to follow Christ and to serve this congregation in His name? Will you do all in your power? Well, this is addressed to the congregation. And the answer is we will, resoundingly. Will you do all in your power to support these leaders with your prayers, your honest yet gracious communications with them, and your willingness to help them carry out Christ's ministry in this church? In the name of this congregation, I commission you for this work and pledge you our prayers, encouragement, and support. May the Holy Spirit guide and strengthen you, that in this and in all things you may do God's will in the service of the kingdom of Christ. And Almighty God, look with favor upon these persons who have now reaffirmed their commitment to follow Christ and serve in His name. Give them courage, patience, and vision. Strengthen us all in our Christian vocation of witness to the world and of service to others. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Thank you all.